have been learning over the last several weeks that God is a relational God. And He's created us for relationship with Himself and with others. But we've also been learning that Satan, he's out to, and sin will destroy our relationship with God and with others. And so all these truths we've been learning, they're important, and they teach us that we need to know God and we need to grow in God. But in this knowing and in this growing in our relationship with God and others, there's so much more we need to understand. So starting this week, we're going to begin to go further in our understanding. We're going to look at 7 parts to consider concerning our relationship with God and with others. I want to say something just to engage our thinking, something to meditate on. And here it is. We are not just to know God, but we are to make God known. So for this to take place, God has said something very clear to us, and it's a command. He said, go and make disciples. Go tell other people about my love for them. This is the call on our lives. It is to go and make disciples. Yet so many believers do not fully understand what all's involved in this. But God wants us to understand it. And that's why we're going to unpack these truths in the weeks ahead. Now, I want to leave you with some thoughts, some words, some insights that Oswald Chambers wrote down many years ago, and here's what he said. He said, it is easier to serve God without a vision. In fact, it's easier to work for God without a call, because then you are not bothered by what God requires. Common sense is your guide. Veneer it over with Christian sentiment. But if once you truly hear the full commission of Jesus Christ, the awareness of what God wants, then it will be your goal from that point on. And you will no longer be able to work for Him on the basis of common sense. So I say, let's determine. Let's make sure that there is no more human common sense veneered over with Christian sentiment. Instead, let's hear the call of God. Let's embrace the call of God. Let's go for God and His glory. That's what I'm praying for. That's what I'll be preaching for God's glory, that we understand how to go. So I look forward to worshiping with you this Sunday.